Hi guys, this is Bea. Welcome back to Believe Studio. So today we are going to be talking about a different topic, which is SB19. So kung hindi nyo pa sila kilala, or well, most likely you've already heard of them, SB19, short for Sound Break 19, is actually a P-pop boy group or Pinoy pop boy group under a Korean company dito sa Pinas, which is yung ShowBT Philippines, headed by business owner and former comedian na si Robin Gong. These days, I've been seeing a lot of people on YouTube reacting to SB19. Parang yung mga foreigners na de-discover nila SB19 during this quarantine. I don't know kung paano siya nangyari. Is it because na-compare sila sa Kachi or what? But anyway, yung Kachi na yan, that's a topic for another day. But seeing these foreigners react to SB19, giving them lots of good praise and attention, kind of makes me feel like as a local na K-pop fan, na natutuwa din naman ako when I hear it. And actually, I've heard of SB19 before pa, when they released their song, yung Go Up. Pinakinggan ko sila before and actually did like that song. I enjoyed listening to Alab. Pinakinggan ko din yung Tila Luha as well as yung Ikako na nilabas nila recently. Someone who's been a local K-pop fan for a very long time, and by that I mean nung era pa ng Super Junior, 21, Girls' Generation, Wonder Girls, Big Bang, yung mga songs nila, the first time those songs hit the Philippines, which was like 9 or 10 years ago when I was in 3rd year high school. In fact, na-meet ko din si Stel tsaka si Josh when they used to be in a BTS cover group called Seon. Nag-perform sila sa UST dati nung nasa college pa ako. And it was really nice to see them perform because they were very good. In fact, nagtaka pa nga ako nun when I heard na nag-disband yung group na yun. But anyway, so as someone who's been a K-pop fan, na local, na Pilipino, for that long, I can tell you for sure, people were not as accepting before as they are now. So I think for SB19 to make a move to be a Pinoy boy band, being under a Korean company, is actually more of a challenge to get accepted in their own home country as compared to overseas. The fact that SB19 was able to create a good and stable fan base here in the Philippines, which is yung atin. So yung local fan base nila is very, very supportive. And kung ano yung loyalty ng isang K-pop fandom to a K-pop band. If you've ever been a K-pop fan, you know what I mean. Parang nagkaroon din ng ganun kind of bond with atin and SB19. And I think that's something that local entertainment companies should look into kung paano nagkakaroon ng ganun kagandang bond between the artist and the fans. Bilang isang Pilipinong K-pop fan for quite some time, I also wanted to share my two cents kung bakit they received such good attention, even though nung una nga medyo close-minded tayong mga Pinoy about K-pop. What I feel that SB19 did to be able to garner this much good praise, and not just overseas, but most importantly here within their own country. Number one is songwriting. When you're a K-pop fan, the first thing that you will appreciate, at least for me, when you hear a K-pop song, isn't the lyrics right away. It's the melody of the song. Because that's the first thing that you will hear, the melody. And when you find that you like the way that the song flows, if you like the way that the melody of the song is, you get to be interested in searching the lyrics and understanding the meaning behind that song. So that goes for K-pop music, from my experience. But the good thing about SB19 is, as soon as you hear the song, the moment they sing, you don't have to search what they mean because you will understand. Because it's in your native language. So that's what's really nice about SB19. And the most important thing is, hindi siya cringy. It's not cringeworthy. Like my sister and I, when we first listened to Go Up, we felt that the way the lyrics were written was very nakakabagay siya dun sa mismong melody ng kanta. If the song was written in a different way, using different words, even if the melody was good, if you didn't pair it up with the right lyrics, hindi din kasing ganda yung magiging kalabasan as it is now. And that's also what's impressive after finding out that SB19 writes their own lyrics, is that they are able to create good lyrics in Tagalog that go well with K-pop melodies or with the melodies of their song. So it just shows that they have talent in songwriting. Next is their choreography. So I also heard that they do their own choreography. And if you haven't watched their dance practice for Go Up, I highly encourage you to watch it. Kasi ito din daw yung naging viral and yung nag-trending, which enabled them to be propelled into the limelight. So somebody shared this dance practice video of them, and then the rest was history. So it's really impressive that they do their own choreo, and not only that, but they execute it very well. K-pop bands are known for their synchronized dancing na kahit anong pagpalit pa yan ng formation. As in, sabay-sabay talaga sila sumayaw, and that's something that SB19 was also able to achieve. Third is basically the overall execution of their concept. Being a Pinoy boy group under a Korean company, something that's never really been done before. So yung pag-receive sa kanila or how people will accept them could have gone either way, but because they executed it so well, kaya siya na-accept ng mabuti ng mga tao. For me, that's what I think. Kasi they could have stopped with making good music that has a Korean vibe in it, pero yung lyrics Tagalog. So that's already very good. And then yung pagsayaw din nila, the way that they do their synchronized dancing is also very good already. But they didn't just stop there. Talagang they went all out with the execution. They have their own band cheer.
Get in the zone! Break! Hi everyone, we are SB19! Yeah!
Each member of the group has their own title.
Hello everyone! I'm the sexiest main dancer of SB19. It's your boy Ken.
Gandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. I'm SB19's Heavenly Voice. My name is Stel. Nice to meet you all.
Gandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Ako po ang leader ng SB19. My name is Sergio. Nice to meet you.
Good evening po sa inyong lahat. Ako po ang pinakamabait na bunso. My name is Justin.
Gandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. I'm the most charismatic member of SB19. My name is Josh.
And aside from the dance practice videos, which is already a common staple among K-pop groups to release, they also have Korean elements in their music videos. Like if you watch Tila Luha, yung actors din sa music video nun was Korean, kahit na yung kanta Tagalog. As well as sa Alab, yung parang fortune teller lady dun, Koreana din siya. And yung pag-promote nila sa sarili nila sa YouTube channel. And they do variety show activities, like ginawa nila yung random play dance. They did the whisper challenge. Nagkaroon sila ng switch parts. And pati yung pagsayaw ng naka-blindfold. So these are all things that K-pop groups also do. Talagang they went all out. Nung sinabi nilang kami ay isang P-pop boy group that's under a Korean label. Talagang lahat ng strategies na ginagawa ng K-pop groups, they implemented it and they made it local, they made it theirs, they added their own twist to it, and that's something I feel that local entertainment industries dito sa Pinas, I think that they're kind of missing out for not thinking of doing the same thing, kasi hindi na sikreto na, alam mo yun, ang dami ng fans ng K-pop at K-drama dito. We spend money to go to their concerts, and it's always such a big deal. Laging puno yung Araneta, laging puno yung MOA. And like, when we even spend for their fan meets, like si Bench, pag nagdadala siya ng kung sino mang Korean actor, like sila Sojun, and all, si Nam Joo-hyuk as well. So, it's no secret that there is a market. There is a local market for this, and I think it was very creative and very wise of ShowBT Philippines and SB19 to integrate these K-pop strategies and see if it will work in the local market. So yeah, I think they're doing a pretty good job. So ayan, those were my thoughts, you know, as somebody who's been a local K-pop fan for so long, about why SB19 is doing as well as they do. I think they're doing a great job, and they should just continue doing things the way that they are, and they'll definitely go up just like their song suggests. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to leave a thumbs up, like, and subscribe if you're into the content. And I'll see you all on the next video. Bye!